Hi, I'm Helena, founder of the Urban Garden Companion, and today I want to share with you some quick tips on getting rid of aphids. As you can see, I've got a bit of an aphids infestation happening on my Asclepias tuberosa, my butterfly milkweed. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take my diatomaceous earth billow, just move back here, and I'm going to squeeze it onto my aphids. What I do is aim to hit the guy right in the sucker. Small down here on the stem. So make sure you go all the way down to the roots, because as you can see here, I've got a lovely little bunch happening at the base there. I've topped up my diatomaceous earth hitter. That's a really good hit. So diatomaceous earth is old fossil minerals, and it's very soft to the touch for us, but for a lot of bugs, it cuts into them. So it cuts into their fleshy bodies and it acts like razor blades. Pretty amazing stuff. I've got a few more there. So I've hit that out. Here's some more of my rose milkweed. So I'm gonna hit those guys with a nice batch of diatomaceous earth. I'm really running empty on this really quickly because I'm hitting it hard. Another way you can get rid of aphids is by squishing them between your fingers. I know it's gross, but it works, and I do have a latex glove on. I'm back at my milkweed 2 days after I've dusted it, and you can see these guys moving. It didn't work as well on this plant with just the diatomaceous earth as it did on the plant that I squished them between my fingers. Let me show you. When I come over to the plant that I squished the aphids between my fingers, I've had much better results. I don't see any aphids on the leaves or on the stems, and they seem to have all disappeared and not made any more babies. One can conclude that it is a combination of diatomaceous earth, squishing aphids between your fingers, and spraying the plant down with water and a bit of soap, so some soapy water so they can't hold on, to get rid of the actual problem. Here's a few here. I just found some. Let me see if these guys are moving. No, they seem to be dead to me. You can tell when you've had a successful aphid slaughter because they look dehydrated. They look shriveled up and kind of very dry. I want to get this in focus a bit more. And when they're alive, they're moving. That guy is moving. See that? He's about to die, but right now he's moving. Thanks for watching. I'm Helena, founder of the Urban Garden Companion, and I really look forward to seeing you all here next time.